Hold on, Kayode. I'm going to come back to you, but there's something significant that we want to do now on the show. Earlier today, the House of Reps told the Nigerian Football Federation that they must do something to honor the memory of Samuel Okparaji because of the circumstances surrounding his death and the lack of insurance because of the sacrifice for Nigeria. His club didn't pay the insurance that was due to him because they told him, if you get injured or you die outside of this environment, we will not be paying you anything, and he was okay with it. But let's quickly go to Abuja now. Honorable Ayo Tajudeen is joining us on Sports Tonight. Let him shed more light on what actually happened and the directive that they gave the Nigerian Football Federation to immortalize Samuel Okparaji. Honorable, thank you for joining us on Sports Tonight.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure.
Please. I mean, can you shed more light on all that went down today as it relates to immortalizing Samuel Okparaji?
Thank you. The House, in a unanimous decision today, based on a motion, has privileged to move on the floor of the House. Today be the 26th year of his death. I agree on about five resolutions. One, that the number six jersey should be retired in honor of Sam Okparaji. Two, that a top state, the Army Stadium, should be named after him by federal government. Three, that the NFF should, as a matter of urgency, visit his family and find a way to ameliorate the suffering of the family. Why is this very important? Just like you rightly said, we discovered that he came to play for Nigeria against his insurance policy. So the family lost the insurance claim they would have received after his death. And he died at the age of 24 with a master's degree. Apart from the kind of investment the parents had made on him, he had him.
Wow, we lost the call, but we must get that call back online. But before we do that, I mean, Kayode, exactly the point we were making. He came to play for Nigeria against his insurance policy.
Remember, Mark Vivian Foy, the family collects money till today.
Mm.
He died playing for Nigeria, playing
for Cameroon.
In the Confederations Cup. His federation stood up and said, you know what? I mean, they didn't need to do much because even FIFA knows it. Well, some of Karaji too is a World Cup event.
At 24.
A World Cup
qualifying game. A FIFA event.
Exactly. So, maybe, you see, I was telling you earlier before his call, I said something happened. For the president of Nigeria Football Federation, he picked the call, called Okaraji's family, the mom. Trust me, when I called them, they were celebrating. They were very happy. For the first time in 28 years, somebody from the Nigeria Football Federation, somebody from the National Sports, in 26 years that is dead, nobody from the NFF, nobody from National Sports Committee or Nigerian government has ever called them. It's not just about the money or whatever they can give them or whatever, the sense of well-being. And that's the second time it was happening. Some years ago, I told Alhaji Maigari, former NFF president, I said, Mudia Lawal is going to be 20 years. He accepted. You know, he accepted because he embraced the idea, met with Muda Lawal's wife and two children in London. We made the three children here, went to Abuja for the match we didn't qualify for against Guinea. So it's very interesting. Things are happening.
Sorry to cut you, Kayode. Let's go back to Abuja very quickly because this is very, very key. And meet up again with Honorable Ayo Tajudeen. Honorable, thank you for getting back to us on the line. You were talking about the five points that you unanimously agreed upon in the House earlier today.
Yeah, and that the Imo State government that have promised to have a minister named after him 20 years after that promise, nothing tangible has been done. That we urge the state government to urgently do something to immortalize him, and that the state government too should deliberately do something to uplift the suffering of the family. We came up with this resolution, which was, well debated on the floor, that if at this turning point when Nigerians are crying for patriotism, if those who are sacrificed for this country are not appreciated or immortalized, or what encouragement or what signal are we sending to the younger generations, If we want them to show concern about what matters to Nigeria, we must show too that when in the course of this they lose their life, the country will not abandon them. No sane nation, no nation attain development without showing reasonable appreciation to those who are sacrificed to make a mark for the nation. So that was what led to that such resolution in the House of Reps.
Well, Honorable Ayotajudeen, thank you so much for speaking to us on Sports Tonight. We are happy that those who are making our laws in Nigeria are beginning to look in this direction of patriotism. And we hope that at the end of it all, in a few weeks, we can look back and see tangible things being done for the family of Samuel Okparaji based on all that you've done today in the House. All right, we've been speaking to Honorable Ayotajudeen, representing Kababunu. That's in Kogi State. Interestingly, that's where that's my side, and I'm honored that someone from that side is doing this for Samuel Okparaji. It shows how football cuts through ethnic divide, tribal divide, and can go a long way, unifying us as a people.
Let me tell you, I'm just absolutely happy today. You know why? Yesterday, without the NFL president's call, I was like, wow. The Nigerian Football Federation president is ready. He called them. Like I told you, it's not about the money. It's about the
well being,
the intention, the realization that it needs to do this. Just a day later, this is coming from the National Assembly. It tells you exactly what we're talking about, that they are responding. You know, don't forget to, I mean, kudos to Channel City, kudos to this program, kudos to everybody. Don't forget that we did it with Muda Lawal. The next day is burial site that we showed.
In Ogun State?
They are renovating it now. So things are happening. Everybody too is going to know that, listen, this is really good. And I must say this, the NFF should just go ahead because I like the momentum. Mm. I like what they're doing. They should go ahead and talk about insurance.
Key.
Life insurance
Key.
For players.
I was going to come to that. I mean, the Honorable told us, Honorable Tajudeen told us, Okparaji came to play against his insurance policy. Unfortunately, he paid the ultimate price.
Unfortunately, his family is in court now, but I'm sorry, I'm not sure, because what they said is, if you travel outside of Europe and Americas to play, that's what their lawyer got.
Let me read this from the Nigerian Football Federation. I mean, this came on earlier today on the Twitter handle of the Nigerian Football Federation, and they said it is in memory of a patriot. Quoting Samuel Okparaji, what he told his manager back then, he says, I am a lawyer. And I signed to play football for certain conditions. But I didn't think it included reselling my services to my country. You or your club cannot stop me from playing for my country. Let me tell you, I am going to represent my country whether you like it or not. These were the words of Samuel Okparaji telling